Hi, my name is Nikki Seward, and this particular video looks at the value of the increased exports from the Delta from the year 2000 to 2009. Well, all these plans have been going on, and the fish species have been declining, and many of the marinas and waterways have been experiencing a huge increase in Egeria densa, which is an invasive water species, and we've been seeing more and more shoaling in different areas. So while this is going on, there have been more exports of water from the Delta, as based on documents from the Delta Council at this website that's noted right here. So the graph below shows the amount of water that has been exported from the Delta in the last two decades, or actually the amount of reported exports. Since DWR measures water flow differently than standard flow measures, the accuracy of measurements for after 2000 should always be questioned. In any case, the graph below shows exports increase from 47 million acre feet per year to 54 million acre feet per year on average. That's an increase of 7 million acre feet per year, which is a value of 8.4 billion per year. 8.4 billion per year. Now, when we talk about plans, they talk about plans for exporting 15,000 cubic feet per second. Well, that means another extra 8.4 billion on top of that, most likely. So let me show you. I'm going to pull up how I got to these numbers. 1 acre foot, they say online at least, says supplies 2 average households with drinking water according to online sources. And as you can see, the exports, this shows the exports. This came from this website. This was 1 million acre feet, so I had to convert it down to 1,000 acre feet to use the conversion tables that you see in the other videos. 7 million acre feet per year, which was the increase in exports, means 14 million additional households were supplied with drinking water, roughly. In Southern California, the average household will spend between $35 and $300 per month for water, depending on the location. Let's use an average of $50 per month, or $600 per year, for the average household water costs. I got that from the national average, which is $51 per online resources. So if you take $600 for a year, and there are 14 million additional households that were supplied with water, that comes to this amount, which is $8.4 billion per year. So this was water that was exported. This is additional to all the previous exports. This has been going on over the last 10 years as all the planting's been going on and the fish species have been declining. So I wanted to, this is a graphic, it just, the future of Steamboat Slough and Sacramento River, if this continues, if they move forward with doing the 15,000 cubic feet per second, which we already established, the Sacramento River only has 17,000 cubic feet, or 17,000 TAF on average each year, and they're proposing to basically divert all of the Sacramento River and just leave a little bit for environmental flows. So what happens is Steamboat Slough and Old Sacramento River, this is just a sketch, you know, everything gets exported down to Southern California, at least outside the Delta, and we just show moving trucks and face plant, this particular water ski face planted. I like that one. And this was a collaborative effort sketch, by the way, that we commissioned. According to California Department of Waterways, prior to 2003, the average water year, like 2000, the annual fresh water on the Sacramento River was 17,000 TAF. Of that flow, 5 to 6,000 TAF of the Sacramento River was diverted through the Delta Cross Channel Gates and Georgiana Slough. That was the highest that was before exported. 11,000 TAF or more per year continued down the natural original waterways of Elk Slough, Sutter Slough, Steamboat Slough, and Old River. Elk Slough really didn't have that much flow. That's one of the areas they're proposing of increasing, apparently. Old River Sacramento is that area of the Sacramento River below Georgiana Slough and Ida Isle, or Vieira's Isleton area, I guess you could say. Then past, the water would flow past Rio Vista to the Suisun Bay and San Francisco Bay. These documents are all found online. You can also find them at deltarevision.com. If you look at the Sacramento River flow copies of all the other past documents. Anyway, the new Delta plan for 2012 proposes export up to 15,000 cubic feet per second from Sacramento River. That creates a capacity to export 10,000, almost 11,000 TAF away from the Sacramento River and its tributaries, basically doubling the amount of water already exported from the Sacramento River. No new canal will be needed. The increased export can be facilitated using Mulqueen River conveyance and Central Canal system already built with modifications. That no new canal needed is from a USBR slideshow presentation. Go to the video presentations about counting water flow to see that. Anyway, that leaves only about 6,000 TAF per year of fresh water flow to share between four natural waterways, which have been splitting 11,000 TAF. Such a drastic reduction in fresh water flow will substantially degrade overall water quality in the north, in the noted North Delta waterways, especially Steamboat Slough and Old River Sacramento. This also will negatively affect the prime farmlands of Grand Island, Ryer Island, Sutter Island, Merritt Island, at a minimum, because they will not have the water to export to do their farming. So again, all of this is based on the actual numbers provided by the state, and exporting 15,000 cubic feet per second of water flow from the Sacramento River is going to drastically affect the natural waterways of the North Delta. Thank you for listening.